At the genesis of all this violence, a poorly made film called Innocence of Muslims, a movie depicting the Prophet Muhammad as a violent buffoon, a movie which may also reflect growing tensions between Islam and the Coptic Church, the largest Christian church in the Middle East. U.S. federal officials believe the man who made the film is Nakula Basili Nakula, who was convicted 3 years ago for bank fraud. A production staffer who worked on the movie says the filmmaker also went by the name Abinab Nakula Basili and said he believed he was a Coptic Christian. The staffer says the filmmaker told him he'd been in Alexandria, Egypt, where the Coptic Church is based, raising money for the film. The suggestion that cops were involved in the movie inflamed Egyptian media.
Islamist use of this idea that cops were behind it was apparently effective in drumming up support for those attacks.
Analyst Eric Traeger and a Coptic Church official tell us there's no connection between the Coptic Church itself and the movie. But the film was promoted by a man who identifies himself as a Coptic Christian, Egyptian-born anti-Islam activist Morris Sadek. In an interview with the Middle East Media Research Institute last year, Sadek said this.
Every Muslim knows that he is one of Egypt's occupiers.
CNN has tried repeatedly and unsuccessfully to reach Morris Sadek.
An official with the Coptic Church here in the U.S. told us the church strongly condemns this film. The church issued a statement calling the movie abusive and part of a malicious campaign to divide people. As for Morris Sadek, the Coptic official said the church has no connection to him and certainly doesn't sanction what he says.
Egypt's Coptic Church is roughly 2,000 years old. Coptic Christians make up almost 10% of Egypt's population, and there's a long history of animosity between them and radical Muslim groups. The bombing of a Christian church in Alexandria last year killed at least 21 people. Another two dozen Coptic Christians and their supporters were killed last fall in clashes with the Egyptian army.
How far back does this tension go, and what's the reason for it?
The reason for the tension is, I think, really due to the violence that cops have experienced both under the previous regime and since that regime collapsed. And I think that that has really fueled mistrust.
Traeger says it's estimated about 100,000 cops have tried to leave Egypt since the revolution last year. Brian Todd, CNN, Washington.